attacking.
No,
number of years ago, did prepare a number of ponies at Lockerbie. I hate counting. People so often say, how many ponies have you got? Well, I think if you ever count how many friends you've got, well, you don't, do you? You just enjoy being around them, and that's really what's happened at home. And, you know, we always invite people to your locals, do come and see what we do. We do, as I say, specialise in driving for people with disabilities, special needs, additional needs, and anybody else who wants to come along and have a jolly good time. And the ponies are so sweet. We've got a donkey, we've got pet sheep, we've got lots of poultry. So very exciting. So, but two of the ponies are staying. Sorry, I did get a bit sidetracked. That's another way about this. Two ponies before said, an artificial world record. Would you believe that Guinness Book of Records refused to accept the category of show jumping carriages? They said, we've never heard of it, can't do it. Which was a shame, but we did see the record. We took the two ponies over a distance of 300 metres with 12 jumps. And we also did the long jump, and we took the carriage 6 metres in the air, which really is quite amazing when you think carriages are supposed to stay on the ground. So we're going to come down to just there. And we're just going to see what they're going to do this afternoon. We'll be a little bit careful. We can't quite get the speeds up that we would do coming down. We can't just come in 18 miles an hour. Coming round the corner, let's see what we can do. Remember, a foot of error of just 4 inches. Oh, that was absolutely rubbish. So were you lot, actually. You didn't encourage them at all. Now, what did I say to you earlier? Encourage them to be going fast. Have you forgotten that? Now, come on, ladies. If you want something done, what do you say to your chap? Yeah, exactly. Good chap. Come on, let's do something. You got the right idea, but kind of a bit late, actually. Thank you very much. So what are we going to do? Maybe we need to have an incentive to encourage you to cheer. So I tell you what we'll do, we'll jump over somebody. What does that sound like? Should we jump over someone? Yeah, that sounds a good idea. And I think I'll nominate my husband. That's an even better idea, because he won't sue me if I land on him. Okay, so right. Got to think of these things, you know. It's really important. When you've got over 50 horses to feed, haven't got any spare cash, I can assure you. Okay, so, not yet. So I'm going to come round here. Now, you ready for this? Let me just tell you that ponies do not normally jump over people. Like, it's not the usual thing. They will do their best to miss them. So are you ready for me to jump over, John? Can't really hit. Come on, lots of children. Yeah, come on, get cheering. I need him to drive the wagon home. There we go. Off we go. Hop, 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 hop. Yay! Absolutely slick! Johnny! Give it! Absolutely, and Kelvin, if you could just watch how far away the ponies land, that would be absolutely fabulous. You get the hang of this. Well, actually, it's the ponies that love you to inspire them. That's what it's all about. That's the motto of our business, is ponies inspiring people. And they really do. And as I say, you're very welcome to come back to the wagon. Chat to us. Are we ready? Have you got some belly beans? Yes, all right. Checked his feet, pointed that side in, and away we go. Well done, that's what we want. Okay. Come on. We're that long way off. Go on then, Calvin, you get in. That's pretty good way, isn't it? Yeah, just get you in. Well done, Scotty, you're on the end. Put Kelvin in the middle, bless him. He doesn't very often come to help us. They don't really want to fish him on the first time. This is amazing, ladies and gentlemen. These ponies are tiny. We've had to bring our smallest ponies the size of the arena. And they are Shetland. And they're only about 2 inches. So that's a big jump in this case. The boy's probably been a crack. Are you ready? Three people. And I'll tell you now, Bumble has never jumped three people. He's got to do this. Whoa! There we go! Fantastic! Well done! And the boys have got up. And that's thanks to you. That's Bumble's first time ever jumping three people. So what a good lad. And that's because you're so enthusiastic. Thank you very much for that. So that's our pair of ponies. We're just going to let them get their breath back. And I'm going down to the collection ring. And we're going to get another incredible pony the one that you saw Steffi race through. And I can tell you a little bit more about it once I'm on. Thank you. Away we go. Quick change across. Rain, thanks very much. And off we go. In. And round again. Good boy. And I won't go too far. Thank you. This pony, as I said to you, was rescued and he was pitted with it. I mean, it was just a complete embarrassment that anybody could have allowed a pony to go into such a state. And he certainly seriously come back to life. He's been an incredible member of the display team for a number of years. But he also, which is even more amazing when you think what his main day job is, he actually won the Novice Pony Indoor Championship for Scotland with a young man with cerebral palsy, which is really absolutely phenomenal that this pony put aside his desire for speed and was really safe and listened to the young man, and it was just the most wonderful moment. He drove it three times to get the number point, and he just always wants to drive back to be so fast, but I don't always let him. Another pony's not quite so fast. So he has had a little bit of competing with some of our drivers. I've also competed him. But this really is his speciality. He's a little bit like Alan Sugar, actually. You know, he loves to work, and he actually doesn't mind what he says on the way to the top. And I think that's very appropriate, because he doesn't actually take prisoners at all, this pony. He just, you look at his ears, you saw him when he went around with Steffi, let me work, let me work. So the fire's done. The boys are just doing the last minute detail in order to make this work. It should be spectacular, there's no wind, so the flames will be quite high. And you know, a lot of people say to me, do you have to desensitize the pony? Do you have to train him to do the fire? Is it cruel? Well, I can assure you, absolutely passionately assure you, we never ever do anything with our ponies that they don't like. We would never put them through something just for the sake of it. And we don't ever practice at home. The ponies, if we ever put a new pony into the fire stud, we'll do it in the ring. We're very, very open. We don't use artificial training methods. We don't use strong driving bits. And we certainly, although I carry a whip, we do that to direct. We would never be able to do anything. And I think in a second, once the boys have got the fire lit, we're just going to let the pony do the talking, and you'll be able to make up your own mind. And if you do want to talk to me afterwards, I'd be absolutely delighted. But this is one amazing guy. And there's lighting, and let's go to the music, Alan. That would be fantastic. Thank you. Believe it or not, it's quite hard to get the flames going in this weather, because the sun takes the field away. What we call our H formation. And they are doing And there you go, ladies and gentlemen, that is Mad Max with the Fire Squad. Thank you so much for watching. Do please come back later. We're on just at the back at 2:15. And come and see, we're going to do a really unusual driving formation for you. Hopefully, we are quite small, we will do our best. Mad Max, ladies and gentlemen. Fantastic pony, and you go and enjoy. Thank you for watching, and you just enjoy this fantastic festival. Thank you very much indeed.